Hey guys, TeamNet91 here, and holy crap am I excited just by what I found on Twitter this morning, in which case, you know me, I had to do a little bit of research on top of that, but of course, and yeah, today's video is going to be a little bit different. Obviously, if you've read the bit down below, we're talking about Sonic Movie 2 today, my definite opinions on it of what we've got thus far from the different leaks happening and popping up from set photos. Specifically, we're going to be talking about a specific set that got me onto this whole thing, as well as some of the general knowledge that we have been alerted to. But yeah, if you can tell, I don't have a script today, and that's mostly because of my excitement. I don't want in order to burn myself out writing the script and then leave this alone. I want to get this info out as quick as I can, especially seeing how this specific image that I'm talking about, I've only seen only one other person cover thus far. And while he did do a pretty good job, he didn't go as in-depth as I'm going to do in this video. So, for those of you who haven't been paying attention, the Sonic Movie 2 is currently shooting. It has many different locations they're going to be doing. They're even shooting stuff here in Seattle. While I haven't personally seen any of the actual shots, we do know that they have sanctioned off parts of the city in order to get specific things, which means that there could potentially be a couple of shots done here, whether or not it has actors or it's just sweeping shots of the city in order to do for something similar to what happened with San Francisco, then, hey, that's up on them. We still don't entirely know. What we do know about this movie is, of course, that it's going to be involving Sonic, Tails, and Knuckles. And, of course, personally, the more you draw from the actual games and the franchise as a whole, the better, and that's exactly what this tweet has done for us. The tweet I'm referring to is posted by Hollywood North Buzz, to which case they say, Fort Langley is under siege. The tanks have rolled into Fort Langley, the new Green Hills for the Sonic the Hedgehog sequel. Can Robotnik be far behind? Hashtag Sonic Movie 2. Now then, they posted this along with three images, which are leaks from the set. And these are actual tanks, APC, and a helicopter, all related to the Guardian United... I'm trying to remember the abbreviation. It's GUN. It's G-U-N. They have the G logo on them. They are G-U-N. Holy crap. Yes. Now then, looking through it, we do have a tank. We have two different types of APCs with three vehicles. For those of you who have no idea what the heck an APC is, that means an armor per... It means a armor personnel carrier. And then, of course, we have the helicopter, which many people on Twitter were quick in order to point out that it has an SA-2 on it, which many people are thinking that it's a reference to Sonic Adventure 2, which case it is, but not in the way that you think. If you pay attention to the other vehicles in this, you'll notice they have other SA designations on them when you're actually viewing. So, for instance, the tank has SA-14 on it, and some of the EPCs, trying in order to look in it, are labeled with ST or different numericals and a few other stuff, to which case you might be wondering, well, what did I mean? Well, it's actually short for Sigma Alpha, which is a designation used in-universe in Sonic Adventure 2 for military vehicles. Specifically, the helicopter in the beginning of Sonic Adventure 2 is labeled as Sigma Alpha 2. So this helicopter is actually a direct reference to Sonic Adventure 2 by being the Sonic Adventure 2 helicopter that was used in order to arrest Sonic on behalf of the United States military, or as they tried spinning it in Sonic X, the United States military. So what exactly does this mean for the plot? Does this mean that we're going to get Shadow? No. Personally, I don't think we're going to get Shadow in this movie. I do not expect them in order to do that. I'm expecting the involvement of G-U-N here in Sonic Movie 2 in order to be a whole setup for a potential third movie where we would get Shadow and potentially the entire plot of Sonic Adventure 2 done in movie format. To which case, if they do that, hell the F, yes, that makes me even more excited for the third movie. But, of course, that's just, the whole bit. And, yeah, we all know how that goes. But what does that mean for the exact plot of this movie? I'm still not entirely sure. We know that Eggman will potentially be returning. We know that Knuckles, of course, is going to be involved, and Tails is going to be heavily involved. So, personally, I think we will either see a mishmash of events of Sonic the Hedgehog 3 and Knuckles being played out. Maybe even a little bit of elements from Sonic 2 of the Sonic 2 classic game in the beginning. If not, then we'll probably be getting the plot of Sonic Adventure 1, and we will be seeing the unleashing of Chaos, which personally will be freaking awesome if we were to get Chaos for the second movie, because goddamn, that'd be cool. Either way, though, it just seems like it might be a traditional versus Eggman plot, though. Again, it's still too early to tell. But either way, though, I thought it was pretty interesting in order to go into this. Also, behind the tank, you'll notice that there might also be a reference to Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine with a Mean Bean Coffee House. So I think that's also pretty fun. I know there's a lot of people who are pretty interested in that. Other bits that we know, apparently, whenever the heck we're going to be getting the trailer, the writers have a huge confidence that the actual trailer will blow our socks off. And I know there's also footage floating around of a stunt guy getting thrown up into the air. So there's that going on as well, located outside of that building. Obviously, if you're paying attention, there's a lot of stuff that's fenced off in these pictures, which, of course, you know, is to keep people away in order to make sure that they're not ruining set pieces or anything like that. That's a pretty standard thing on set. But either way, though, yeah, that's what's going on over in Fort Langley. If I'm noticing anything here in the actual city itself, I'll see if I can get exclusive footage. But yeah, thanks for tuning in today, guys. I know that, again, this is a little bit of a different video. Subscribe for more, and of course, I'll actually be covering the Sonic the Hedgehog game next time with full-on script and everything that is currently in production in the works. I just wanted to push this out as quick as I could. Yeah, so anyways, thanks for watching, and until next time, this is TMNDG91, signing out.